Hey you guys, so today I'm coming to you with another makeup tutorial. Makeup tutorials are really big hits on my channel. I didn't realize that until recently that you guys like to watch my tutorials. So today I'm bringing you a look that I've been wearing for about the past week to week and a half. You guys have just loved seeing this look in my vlogs, and also when I post pictures on like Instagram and on Snapchat, you guys are like, tutorial please, tutorial please. So this is a really glowy, golden and dewy look. So I hope you guys enjoy this makeup look, and without further ado, let's get into it. So first, taking my Smashbox Photo Finish Primer, I'm just going to prime my face. This is going to help my foundation last all day. Now taking my L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Foundation in the color Soft Sable, I'm just basically blending this into my skin with a damp beauty blender. Next, taking my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color Toffee, I'm using this to highlight under my eyes, down the bridge of my nose, on my chin, and on my forehead as well. And I'm going to be using the same beauty blender that I used for my foundation to blend in the concealer. Now with my Anastasia Beverly Hills Cream Contour Kit, I'm taking the color Cinnamon to contour, and I'm using my e.l.f. contour brush that I got from Target to carve out the hollows of my cheeks and also to put the color around my forehead. And then I'm just going to go and blend this in with an angled face brush. And I'm also going to apply some of this down the bridge of my nose, which I usually don't do, but with this cream product, I found it really easy to just blend into my skin. With that same damp beauty blender that I used for my foundation and my highlight, I'm going in and using the other side to just blend out my contour to make sure that everything is seamless and so there are no harsh lines. Now taking my MAC Mineralize Skin Fish Powder in the color Dark, I'm applying this all over my face just to set all of my products that I've used. I'm not going to go in and bake with like banana powder or anything, and I'm not going to go in and set my contour with a deeper color. Since this is an everyday look, I don't think that doing all of that is very appropriate. Now going in my Lorac Behind the Scenes eye primer, which is a sample size, I'm just going to use this to prime my eyelids. And then I'm grabbing my Morphe 350 palette, and I'm grabbing this caramel color out, and I'm applying this with my MAC 217 brush into my crease, and this is just going to act as my transition color and also as my crease color. And now going in with this darker color, which is more of a sienna or cinnamon brown, I'm going in with that same brush to just deepen up my crease. And now taking my MAC 224 brush and this light brown color, it's very, very light. It reminds me of Salted Caramel from the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette. I'm just blending out all of those colors that I used in my crease just to make a very pretty gradient and transition. Now going in with my MAC 239 brush and this gold color from the Morphe 350 palette, I'm just going to be applying this all over my lid. I think this is the perfect color to wear every day because it's very close to my skin tone, yet it gives it a little shimmer and a little pop. Now taking that MAC 217 brush, I'm going back into my crease to blend out the edges of that gold eyeshadow I just applied, and just blend, blend, blend. And now going in with the MAC 224 brush with the product that is already left on the brush, I'm just going back in and blending out those colors even more. Next, taking my Too Faced Red and Sex Mascara, I'm just going to be coating my upper lashes before I apply my false lashes. And this is just a little ribbon eyelash case holder, and I'm just grabbing the lashes out of here. So I believe they're the Allure 202 lashes. I'm not entirely sure, but they will definitely be down below. I love these lashes. They're dramatic enough to make my eyes really stand out, but they're not so flashy that they're inappropriate for an everyday look. Now I'm just coating my bottom lashes with that same mascara. So taking my MAC lip liner in the color Cork, I would just be outlining my lips just to prep them for the lipstick that I'm about to put on. Now I'm going in with my lipstick in the color Persistence, which is a matte lipstick color, and I love, love, love this color. At first I was wearing Whirl every single day, but then one of my subscribers suggested this shade, and I like it a little bit better than Whirl because it's a little bit on the warmer side, more so than Whirl is. So I'm just applying this all over my lips and then going back in with that Cork lip liner and then just redefining the outline for my lips. Now, of course, going with my MAC Mineralize Skin Finish in the color Gold Deposit. I absolutely adore this as a highlight. This is what I've been wearing for the past like month and a half now, and I'm not changing anytime soon. And I'm just using this BH Cosmetics face brush to just apply this on the highest points of my cheeks. And then I'm taking this Morphe M200 brush to apply it on my brow bone, down the bridge of my nose, and on my forehead. Last, taking my MAC Fix Plus spray, I'm just going to spray a couple of shots of this all over my face. Most of the time I do forget this step, but I do make sure I do this on an everyday basis. It just gives my makeup more of a dewy finish and it really makes that highlight just really pop. So here's the finished look, you guys. A very pretty, glowy, golden, and dewy makeup look. Very appropriate for everyday wear. And to be quite honest with you all, I've been wearing this every day. Whether I'm going to class or running errands or going on a date with my boyfriend, the eyes and the face makeup for this just goes with any occasion. And sometimes I do switch out the lip color, whether I want to do red or like a gloss or however I'm feeling that day. But I feel like this is just a look that is very appropriate for everyday use and everyday wear, and I think anyone could pull this off. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you all in my next one.